Guardian of Shialkodi. Protector of the Realm. Episode 3 Unraveling the Secrets of the Astral Tower in Ironclad Mines. The night after the battle at Vashgara was filled with a quiet unease. Aryaman, though victorious over Malachar, felt the weight of his responsibility more than ever. He had saved the city, but the shadow of the darkness that threatened Shialkodi was growing stronger. The whispers of Malachar's dying curse echoed in his mind, reminding him that the forces of evil would not relent. As dawn broke, the city of Vashgara was alive with activity. Warriors prepared for the battles yet to come, and the council convened to discuss the next steps in the defense of the realm. Aryaman, Ananya, and Kalaratri were summoned to the council chamber, where the atmosphere was tense but determined. The elder with the white beard, who had initially welcomed Aryaman, addressed the gathering. Aryaman, your victory over Malachar has bought us time, but the darkness that threatens Shialkodi is vast and relentless. We must form a sacred alliance, an unbreakable bond between the mightiest forces in our realm. Aryaman nodded. I agree. We need more than just Vashgara to stand against the darkness. We must rally the other great powers of Shialkodi and forge a united front. The elder continued, there are three key allies we must seek out, the elves of the Evershade Forest, the dwarves of the Ironclad Mountains, and the mages of the Astral Tower. Each holds a unique power that, when combined, can form the sacred alliance needed to repel the dark forces. Ananya stepped forward, her voice filled with resolve. I will go to the Evershade Forest. The elves have long been our allies, and their connection to the natural world makes them invaluable in this fight. I will travel to the Ironclad Mountains, Aryaman declared. The dwarves are known for their unmatched craftsmanship and their indomitable spirit. Their weapons and fortifications could turn the tide of this war. Kalaratri's voice, though ethereal, carried an unmistakable authority. I shall guide Aryaman. My knowledge of the ancient paths will help us reach the dwarves swiftly. But remember, Aryaman, the dwarves are proud and wary. They will not easily pledge their allegiance. The elder then turned to Aryaman with a grave expression. The mages of the Astral Tower are the most enigmatic of all. Their magic is unparalleled, but they are isolated, trusting no one. Convincing them to join the alliance will be your greatest challenge. With their missions clear, Aryaman and Ananya shared a brief but meaningful glance before parting ways. Ananya set off towards the Evershade Forest, while Aryaman, guided by Kalaratri, began the arduous journey to the Ironclad Mountains. The journey was fraught with peril. The path to the mountains was treacherous, winding through dark valleys and across roaring rivers. Yet Aryaman pressed on, driven by his sense of duty and the knowledge that the fate of the realm rested on his shoulders. Kalaratri's presence was a constant comfort, her wisdom guiding them through the most dangerous terrains. As they neared the Ironclad Mountains, Aryaman marveled at the towering peaks that seemed to touch the sky. The mountains were home to the dwarves, a race known for their resilience and mastery of stone and metal. Aryaman knew that convincing them to join the Sacred Alliance would not be easy. The dwarves were a proud people, and their loyalty was hard won. Upon reaching the entrance to the Dwarven Kingdom, Aryaman was met with a formidable gate carved into the mountain itself, guarded by a battalion of heavily armored dwarves. Their leader, a stern-faced dwarf named Thrain Ironfist, eyed Aryaman with suspicion. State your business, traveler, Thrain demanded, his voice echoing in the cavernous entrance. I am Aryaman, guardian of Shialkodi, Aryaman replied, standing tall. I come seeking an alliance with the dwarves of the Ironclad Mountains. The darkness that threatens our realm is growing stronger, and we must stand together if we are to defeat it. Thrain studied Aryaman carefully, his eyes narrowing. The dwarves do not enter into alliances lightly. What proof do you have that this threat is as dire as you say? Aryaman stepped forward, unflinching. I have faced the darkness myself. I have battled the sorcerer Zorath and vanquished Malachar, but their forces are only a fraction of what lies ahead. The realm of Shialkodi will not survive without the strength of the dwarves. Thrain was silent for a long moment, his gaze never leaving Aryaman's. Then, with a nod, he gestured for Aryaman to follow him. Very well. You will speak with King Thoric, our ruler. It is he who will decide if we join your sacred alliance. The halls of the Dwarven Kingdom were magnificent, carved from the living rock and adorned with intricate patterns of gold and silver. Aryaman was led to the throne room, where King Thoric sat upon a grand throne of stone, his presence commanding respect. Aryaman, guardian of Shialkodi, King Thoric began, his voice deep and resonant. Thrain tells me you seek our aid against a great darkness. Speak, and tell me why the dwarves should risk their lives in this war. Aryaman recounted the events leading up to this moment, the growing darkness, the battles he had fought, and the allies he sought to gather. He spoke of the Sacred Alliance and how the strength of the dwarves could tip the balance in their favor. King Thoric listened intently, his expression unreadable. When Aryaman finished, the king leaned forward, his eyes narrowing. You speak with conviction, Aryaman. But the dwarves have their own battles to fight. Our minds are under siege by creatures of the deep, and our people are divided. Why should we join your fight when we cannot even guarantee our own survival? Aryaman paused, considering his words carefully. Because our fates are intertwined. If the darkness consumes Shialkodi, it will not stop at our borders. Your minds, your people, your kingdom, all will fall under its shadow. But if we unite, we can stand against this threat. The dwarves are known for their resilience and strength. Together, we can forge a future where our people live free from fear. King Thoric remained silent, his gaze piercing. After what felt like an eternity, he finally spoke. You are wise beyond your years, Aryaman. The dwarves will join your sacred alliance, but on one condition. Help us reclaim our minds from the creatures that have overrun them, and you will have our loyalty. Aryaman nodded, determination in his eyes. I accept your challenge, King Thoric. Together, we will reclaim your minds and forge the sacred alliance that will save Shialkodi. Answer, the next leg of Aryaman's journey began. With the strength of the dwarves by his side, he prepared to face the challenges that lay ahead. The creatures of the deep awaited, and the path to the sacred alliance was fraught with danger. But Aryaman knew that with courage, resolve, and unity, they could overcome any obstacle. As the guardian of Shialkodi, Aryaman's resolve had never been stronger. The gathering storm threatened to engulf the realm, but with each ally he secured, the light grew brighter. The Sacred Alliance was within reach, and Aryaman would not rest until Shialkodi was safe from the encroaching darkness. With King Thoric's challenge accepted, Aryaman found himself at the forefront of another battle. The dwarves of the Ironclad Mountains had long held their mines as the heart of their kingdom, rich with precious ores and ancient secrets. However, these mines had been overrun by creatures of the deep, ferocious beings born from the darkest corners of the earth. To win the dwarves' loyalty, Aryaman needed to lead them in reclaiming these vital mines. The night before the assault, Aryaman stood in the Dwarven Stronghold's Great Hall, studying a detailed map of the mines. Thrain Ironfist, the stoic dwarven commander, pointed out key areas where the creatures had taken hold. The beasts are led by a creature known as the Stonefiend, Thrain explained, his voice grim. A monstrous being, it commands the others and is responsible for the corruption spreading through the tunnels. If we can take it down, the rest will fall into disarray. Aryaman nodded, his gaze intense. Then we target the Stonefiend. But we must also protect your miners. They are the lifeblood of your kingdom, and without them, the mines are worthless. Thrain grunted in agreement. I, The miners will be protected. We'll evacuate as many as we can before the battle begins. But be warned, Aryaman, the Stone Fiend is a formidable foe. Its skin is as tough as iron, and it commands the very earth beneath its feet. Kalaratri, ever present by Aryaman's side, added, the creature's strength lies in its connection to the earth. If we sever that connection, we may weaken it. With their strategy in place, Aryaman and the dwarves prepared for the battle ahead. As the first light of dawn touched the peaks of the Ironclad Mountains, the assault on the mines began. The entrance to the mines was a massive archway carved into the mountain's face, guarded by heavily armored dwarves. Aryaman, Thrain, and a contingent of elite dwarven warriors descended into the dark tunnels, the flickering light of their torches casting eerie shadows on the walls. As they ventured deeper, the air grew thick with the stench of decay and sulfur. The tunnels, once bustling with the sound of pickaxes and the clatter of ore carts, were now eerily silent. The occasional scuttle of claws on stone echoed through the passageways, a reminder of the dangers that lurked in the darkness. The first wave of creatures struck without warning. Twisted, grotesque beings with stone-like skin and razor-sharp claws surged from the shadows, their eyes glowing with malevolent hunger. Aryaman's blade flashed in the dim light, cutting down the creatures with swift precision. The dwarves fought alongside him, their war cries echoing through the tunnels as they held the line. Despite their ferocity, the creatures were relentless. For every one they felled, two more took its place. Aryaman could feel the pressure mounting as the battle dragged on, the creatures' numbers seeming endless. "We're getting close to the Stonefiend," Thrain shouted over the din of battle. "It won't let us through without a fight." Pushing forward with renewed determination, Aryaman led the charge deeper into the mines. The tunnels opened into a vast cavern, its walls lined with glittering veins of precious metals. In the center of the cavern stood the Stonefiend, a towering monstrosity of rock and earth, its eyes burning with an inner fire. The Stonefiend let out a deafening roar, shaking the very ground beneath their feet. The creature's massive fist slammed into the earth, causing the cavern floor to crack and shift. Aryaman and the dwarves were forced to dodge falling debris as they closed in on their target. Aryaman wasted no time. Channeling the divine energy gifted to him by Goddess Shialkodi, he lunged at the Stonefiend, his blade aimed for the creature's heart. But the beast was faster than it appeared, swatting Aryaman away with a single, devastating blow. He crashed into the cavern wall, the impact jarring but not enough to keep him down. As Aryaman struggled to his feet, Kalaratri's voice echoed in his mind. "Remember, Aryaman, the creature's strength is tied to the earth. You must break its connection." Aryaman focused, drawing upon the power of Shialkodi. He raised his blade high, summoning a burst of divine energy that shot into the cavern's ceiling. The light of the divine energy illuminated the entire cavern, and the ground beneath the Stonefiend began to tremble. Suddenly, the Stonefiend let out a roar of pain as the earth beneath it quaked violently. Cracks spread across the cavern floor, severing the creature's connection to the earth. Its stone-like skin began to crumble, and the fire in its eyes dimmed. "Now, Aryaman," Kalaratri urged. With one final, powerful strike, Aryaman drove his blade into the Stonefiend's chest. The creature let out a final, agonized roar before collapsing into a pile of rubble, its body dissolving into dust. The remaining creatures in the cavern, now leaderless and disoriented, fled into the shadows. The battle was won, but the cost had been high. The cavern was littered with the bodies of fallen dwarves, their sacrifice a testament to their bravery. Thrain approached Aryaman, his expression a mixture of sorrow and gratitude. "You have done what we thought impossible, Guardian. The Stonefiend is defeated, and our mines are ours once more. The dwarves of the Ironclad Mountains will honor their word. We will join your sacred alliance." Aryaman bowed his head, his heart heavy with the loss of life but filled with hope for the future. Together, we will protect Shialkodi from the darkness. Your strength will be a cornerstone of our alliance. With the dwarves now committed to the cause, Aryaman's next challenge lay with the mages of the Astral Tower. The journey ahead would be difficult, but with each ally he secured, Aryaman's resolve grew stronger. The darkness may have been powerful, but united under the Sacred Alliance, the forces of light would stand a chance. As Aryaman and his companions prepared to leave the Ironclad Mountains, Kalaratri's voice echoed in his mind once more. The battle is won, Aryaman, but the war is far from over. The darkness will not rest, and neither must we. With the dwarves as his allies and the bond with Kalaratri strengthening with each victory, Aryaman was ready to face whatever challenges lay ahead. The Sacred Alliance was beginning to take shape, and with it, the hope of saving Shialkodi from the encroaching darkness. With the dwarves of the Ironclad Mountains now part of the Sacred Alliance, Aryaman set his sights on the next and most elusive ally, the mages of the Astral Tower. The mages were known for their immense magical power, but they were also reclusive, existing in a world apart from the rest of Shialkodi. Convincing them to join the alliance would be Aryaman's greatest challenge yet. The journey to the Astral Tower was long and arduous. Kalaratri guided Aryaman through dense forests, over treacherous mountain passes, and across vast plains where the winds howled like restless spirits. The land seemed to grow more mysterious and otherworldly the closer they got to the Astral Tower. The sky was often filled with swirling clouds, and strange, ethereal lights danced on the horizon. As they approached the tower, Aryaman was struck by its otherworldly beauty. The Astral Tower was a massive spire of shimmering crystal, reaching far into the sky. It seemed to pulse with an inner light, casting a gentle glow over the surrounding landscape. The air around the tower was thick with magical energy, making every breath feel charged with power. At the base of the tower, Aryaman was met by a figure clad in flowing robes of deep indigo, a hood obscuring their face. The figure's voice was soft, yet it carried an unmistakable authority. Guardian of Shialkodi, the mages of the Astral Tower have been expecting you. But know this, the path to our alliance is not one that can be walked with words alone. You must prove yourself worthy of our trust. Aryaman nodded, understanding the gravity of the challenge. I am prepared to face whatever trials you require. The darkness is growing stronger, and we need your power to save Shialkodi. The mage gestured for Aryaman to follow, leading him into the heart of the tower. Inside, the tower was a labyrinth of winding corridors and spiraling staircases, all made of the same glowing crystal. The walls seemed to shift and change as they walked, as if the tower itself was alive and observing Aryaman. Finally, they reached a vast chamber at the tower's peak. The room was filled with floating orbs of light, each one holding a piece of ancient knowledge. At the center of the chamber stood a grand altar, surrounded by the seven high mages of the Astral Tower. They were a formidable group, each mage radiating an aura of immense power. The leader of the high mages, an elder with eyes like the night sky, spoke first. Aryaman, guardian of Shialkodi, you seek our aid in the battle against the darkness. But power such as ours is not given lightly. To earn our alliance, you must undergo the trial of the astral flame. Aryaman stood tall, his resolve unshaken. What does this trial entail? The elder's gaze bore into Aryaman's soul. The astral flame is the source of our power. It is a living essence of magic, capable of great creation and destruction. To pass the trial, you must prove your strength, wisdom, and purity of heart by facing the flame itself. Should you succeed, the mages of the Astral Tower will join your sacred alliance. But beware, the flame does not suffer the unworthy. Without hesitation, Aryaman agreed. I accept the trial. I will face the astral flame. The High Mages nodded in unison, and with a wave of the Elder's hand, the chamber transformed. The orbs of light converged at the center, merging into a single, blazing orb that pulsed with raw, unbridled energy. The astral flame hovered above the altar, its light illuminating the entire chamber with a brilliance that was almost blinding. The Elder Mage stepped aside, allowing Aryaman to approach the altar. "Step into the light of the astral flame, and let it judge your worth." Aryaman took a deep breath, feeling the immense pressure of the moment. He closed his eyes and stepped into the light. As the astral flame enveloped him, he felt an overwhelming surge of power, as if the very essence of magic was flowing through his veins. The world around him faded, and Aryaman found himself in a vast, endless void, with the astral flame burning brightly before him. The flame spoke, not with words, but with feelings and images that echoed in his mind. The first trial was one of strength. The flame conjured visions of the battles Aryaman had fought, the enemies he had faced, and the trials he had endured. The challenges were replayed before him, but this time they were more intense, more ferocious. Aryaman fought with all his might, reliving the battles but with the knowledge and experience he had gained. He felt the flame testing his resolve, pushing him to his limits. Yet, each time, Aryaman rose to the challenge, his strength unwavering. The second trial was one of wisdom. The flame presented Aryaman with a series of dilemmas, each more complex than the last. It showed him visions of the future, possible outcomes of the war against the darkness, and the consequences of his decisions. Aryaman had to choose paths that would lead to the greater good, even when the choices were difficult. He had to weigh the lives of his allies, the fate of Shialkodi, and his own desires. Each choice was a test of his wisdom, and each decision brought him closer to understanding the true nature of leadership. The final trial was one of the heart. The flame delved into Aryaman's deepest fears and desires, bringing forth visions of his past, his loved ones, and the sacrifices he had made. The flame showed him Ananya, standing on a cliff's edge, her face filled with sorrow. It showed him the wolf wife he had married to save his life, her eyes filled with love and acceptance. The flame asked him if he could truly balance his duty with his heart, if he could protect those he loved while carrying the burden of the guardian. Aryaman felt his emotions swell, but he remained resolute. "I will protect Shialkodi, and I will honor the love I have for those dear to me. My duty as guardian does not diminish my love, it strengthens it." The astral flame pulsed brightly, its light growing even more intense. Aryaman could feel it probing his very soul, searching for any hint of doubt or darkness. But Aryaman's heart was pure, his resolve unbroken. He had faced the flame and remained true to himself. Suddenly, the void shattered, and Aryaman found himself back in the chamber with the High Mages. The astral flame, now dimmed, returned to its place above the altar. The Elder Mage stepped forward, a look of deep respect in his eyes. "You have passed the trial of the astral flame," the Elder announced, his voice filled with awe. "You have proven yourself worthy of our trust and our power. The mages of the Astral Tower will join your sacred alliance." Aryaman bowed deeply, his heart filled with gratitude. "Thank you. Together, we will stand against the darkness and protect Shialkodi." With the mages of the Astral Tower now part of the alliance, Aryaman knew the Sacred Alliance was nearly complete. The forces of light were gathering, and the time to confront the darkness was drawing near. But Aryaman also knew that the battle ahead would be unlike any he had faced before. The final confrontation with the dark forces of Zorath would determine the fate of the realm. As Aryaman left the Astral Tower, he felt a renewed sense of purpose. The trials had tested him in ways he had never imagined, but they had also strengthened his resolve. The Sacred Alliance was ready, and with the combined strength of the elves, dwarves, and mages, Aryaman was prepared to lead the charge against the darkness. But as the winds howled around him and the skies darkened with the coming storm, Aryaman knew that the true battle had yet to begin. The guardian of Shialkodi would soon face his greatest challenge, and the fate of the entire realm hung in the balance. The sacred alliance was nearly complete. Aryaman had secured the loyalty of the elves, the dwarves, and the mages of the Astral Tower. Each ally brought with them unique strengths and ancient wisdom, and together, they formed a powerful force capable of challenging the darkness. Yet, the final piece of the puzzle was still missing. The mysterious and powerful druids of the Verdant Circle, the guardians of Shialkodi's primal forests. The druids were a reclusive and enigmatic group, even more so than the mages. They lived deep within the Verdant Forest, a place teeming with ancient magic and the spirits of the natural world. The druids' connection to the land was unparalleled, and their power over nature was said to be unmatched. But convincing them to join the Sacred Alliance would be no easy task. The druids had long been wary of the outside world, preferring to keep to themselves and protect the forests in their own way. As Aryaman journeyed to the Verdant Forest, he couldn't shake the feeling that the final battle was drawing near. The skies had grown darker with each passing day, and the winds carried whispers of impending doom. The darkness that threatened Shialkodi was growing stronger, and Aryaman knew that time was running out. Kalaratri, ever watchful, sensed Aryaman's unease. The druids are the last piece we need to complete the alliance. But they are also the most unpredictable. Their power is immense, but so is their isolation. You must approach them with care. Aryaman nodded, his determination unwavering. The druids' power is vital to our cause. I will do whatever it takes to earn their trust and bring them into the alliance. As they entered the verdant forest, Aryaman was struck by the overwhelming sense of life all around him. The forest was alive in a way that was almost tangible, with the trees towering high above and the undergrowth teeming with creatures. The air was thick with the scent of pine and earth, and the light that filtered through the canopy was a soft, golden green. It was a place of ancient power, and Aryaman could feel the eyes of the forest watching him. The journey through the forest was challenging. The paths were winding and overgrown, and the forest itself seemed to shift and change, as if testing Aryaman's resolve. Kalaratri guided him with her innate connection to the natural world, but even she could sense the tension in the air. The forest was alive with the presence of the druids, and they were watching Aryaman's every move. After days of travel, Aryaman and Kalaratri arrived at the heart of the Verdant Forest, a sacred grove known as the Circle of Ancients. The grove was a place of immense power, where the oldest and mightiest trees stood in a perfect circle, their roots intertwined beneath the earth. In the center of the grove was an ancient stone altar, covered in moss and glowing with a faint green light. The air was thick with magic, and Aryaman could feel the presence of the druids all around him, though they remained hidden from sight. Suddenly, the air in the grove shimmered, and a figure appeared before Aryaman. It was a tall, regal woman with flowing green robes that seemed to be woven from the very leaves of the forest. Her hair was a cascade of vines and flowers, and her eyes glowed with an otherworldly light. She was surrounded by a group of druids, each one as mysterious and powerful as the next. The woman, who was clearly the leader of the druids, spoke with a voice that resonated with the power of the earth itself. Aryaman, guardian of Shialkodi, you have come to the sacred grove seeking our aid. But know this, the Verdant Circle does not involve itself in the affairs of the outside world lightly. Why should we, the protectors of the natural world, join your alliance? Aryaman bowed respectfully, feeling the weight of the moment. Great druid, the darkness that threatens Shialkodi does not distinguish between the forests and the cities, the mountains and the plains. It seeks to consume all life, to bring chaos and destruction to the entire realm. Your power is needed to protect not just the Verdant Forest, but all of Shialkodi. The druid leader's gaze was piercing, as if she could see into Aryaman's very soul. The darkness is a force of nature, just as the light is. It is a cycle that has existed since time immemorial. Why should we seek to disrupt this balance? Aryaman took a deep breath, his voice filled with conviction. This is no ordinary darkness. It is a force of pure evil, driven by hatred and malice. It seeks not to restore balance, but to destroy it entirely. If it succeeds, there will be no forests left to protect, no life left to sustain. The very fabric of Shialkodi will be torn apart. We must stand together, all of us, to stop it. The grove fell silent as the druids considered Aryaman's words. The leader of the druids stepped forward, her expression thoughtful. You speak with wisdom, Guardian. But words alone are not enough. The verdant circle has its own trials, its own challenges that must be met before we can consider joining your alliance. Are you prepared to face them? Aryaman nodded without hesitation. I am ready. The druid leader raised her arms, and the grove around them began to change. The trees grew taller, their branches twisting into intricate patterns. The ground beneath Aryaman's feet shifted, and the air became thick with magic. The druids began to chant in an ancient language, their voices blending with the sounds of the forest. The trial of the verdant heart, the druid leader intoned. To prove your worth, you must journey into the heart of the forest, where the ancient spirit of the verdant heart resides. You must seek its blessing, and in doing so, you will prove your connection to the natural world. But beware, for the verdant heart is guarded by the spirits of the forest, and they will not suffer the unworthy to pass. With that, Aryaman was enveloped in a swirling vortex of leaves and light. When the vortex subsided, he found himself standing in a dense, mist-filled part of the forest, far from the sacred grove. The trees here were ancient, their trunks as thick as castle walls, and the air was filled with the sounds of unseen creatures. Kalaratri's voice echoed in his mind. This is the heart of the verdant forest. The spirits here are powerful and ancient. You must tread carefully. Aryaman set off into the forest, his senses on high alert. The path ahead was shrouded in mist, and the trees seemed to close in around him, their branches twisting like grasping hands. The further he ventured, the more the forest seemed to come alive. Strange sounds echoed through the trees, and shadows moved just out of sight. As he journeyed deeper, Aryaman encountered the first of the forest spirits. They appeared as ethereal beings made of light and shadow, their forms shifting and changing like the wind. They spoke in riddles and tested Aryaman's resolve, challenging his understanding of the natural world and his commitment to protecting it. The first spirit, a being of light and fire, asked, "Why do you seek the verdant heart, Guardian? What do you hope to gain?" Aryaman answered, "I seek not for myself, but for all of Shialkodi. The verdant heart's power is needed to protect the realm from the darkness that threatens to consume it." The spirit seemed satisfied with his answer and allowed him to pass. The second spirit, a creature of water and mist, whispered, "The forest has stood for eons, untouched by the affairs of mortals. Why should we aid you in your fight?" Aryaman replied, "The darkness will not spare the forest. It seeks to destroy all life, not just the realms of men. By standing together, we can preserve the balance of nature and protect all living things." The spirit nodded and dissipated into the mist, allowing Aryaman to continue. Finally, Aryaman reached the heart of the forest, where the verdant heart itself resided. It was a massive tree, its trunk glowing with a soft, green light, and its roots spreading deep into the earth. The air around it was filled with the hum of life, the sound of the forest's heartbeat. As Aryaman approached the verdant heart, the final guardian appeared. It was a towering figure made of wood and stone, its eyes glowing with the light of the forest. It spoke with a voice that resonated with the power of the earth. Guardian of Shialkodi, you have come seeking the blessing of the Verdant Heart. But to receive it, you must prove that you are worthy of wielding its power. The Guardian raised its massive hand, and the ground beneath Aryaman's feet began to shake. The roots of the Verdant Heart surged up from the earth, wrapping around him in a constricting embrace. Aryaman struggled, but the roots held him fast, the grip tightening with each passing moment. Kalaratri's voice echoed in his mind. Do not resist, Aryaman. The Verdant Heart is testing your connection to the land. You must surrender to its power. Taking a deep breath, Aryaman closed his eyes and relaxed his body, allowing the roots to envelop him completely. As he did, he felt a surge of energy flow through him, connecting him to the forest in a way he had never experienced before. He could feel the life of the trees, the creatures, and the very earth itself. He understood then that the Verdant Heart was not just a source of power, but a living, breathing entity that needed to be respected and protected. The roots slowly released the grip, and the Guardian nodded in approval. You have proven your worth, Guardian. The Verdant Heart has accepted you. The Druids of the Verdant Circle will join your sacred alliance, and together, we will protect Shialkodi from the darkness. As the Guardian stepped aside, the Verdant Heart pulsed with a bright green light, and Aryaman felt a deep sense of peace and purpose wash over him. The connection he had forged with the forest would strengthen the alliance and give them the power they needed to stand against the darkness. Aryaman returned to the sacred grove, where the druids awaited him. The leader of the druids smiled, her eyes filled with a newfound respect. You have done well, Guardian. The Verdant Circle will stand with you in the battle to come. With the druids now part of the Sacred Alliance, Aryaman felt a sense of completeness. The forces of light were united, and together, they would face the coming storm. The final battle was approaching, and Aryaman knew that the fate of Shialkodi rested on his shoulders. But as he left the Verdant Forest, Aryaman couldn't shake the feeling that the darkness was closer than ever. The skies had grown even darker, and the winds carried the scent of death and decay. The time for preparation was over. The battle for Shialkodi had begun.